Welcome to Jackall Digital. I'm Simon, and today we'll be converting our sketches and drawings into digital art. And we'll start by tracing the lines. I'll show you 5 ways how you can do this. The first one is image trace. The result will depend on the contrast between the background that you use, which is the paper, and the color of the ink or pencil that you use. The result may not be as crisp as you did it by hand, so this will be mainly if you use it for the style. So the one that I'll use is this one. It's kind of a fish, I know, fat fish. So what you do is select the image, click on image trace, wait for it to finish. This can be a slow process depending on the PC. And this is what you get. Probably won't be what you want. So click on the image trace panel, play with the threshold, and maybe adjust the pathing. You'll want to lower the noise so you get more details back, and maybe increase the pathing and corners. It's a decent result, I guess. But what you can do to get a bit better result is to increase the contrast between the lines and the background. And if you use a paper with lines, you can also remove those as much as you can. So if we now image trace this image, we can see that it gets a little bit better result by default. We just need to increase it a little bit. And since the image is also smaller, it doesn't need that much processing power to update. Okay, so between the two, I think this one has a little bit more detail in it. So that's one way you could do it. You would only do this if you want a certain style of look. You won't get smooth and crisp lines. What you can do is also ignore the white, so you get a transparent background if you put this on a t-shirt. So the next tool on the list is the pen tool. You could just left click and make a bunch of points, but these are not smooth points. So what you need to do is to click the left mouse button, drag it until you see the handles. Then you can release it, click and drag again, and make shapes. So if you get to a point like this that has a 90 degree angle, you can hold the mouse button, position the curvature how you want to, hold Alt, and now you can position the handle. Release it and make the next point. Then press A to adjust the points. So as you can see, this point moves together with the right one. But if I hold Alt, I can now move it individually. Of course, if you want to see what's behind it, just remove the color. And you can also lower the opacity of the image. The pen tool is best used with the mouse, but if you have a digital tablet, you can use the next 3 tools with this. And for that, we'll be using either the pencil. If you don't see it, you can press N, or you can hold the left mouse button and select it. Then you have the paintbrush and the blob brush tool. So first you have the pencil, and you can adjust the size of it and the shape. So the pencil is basically just a pencil that you can change some of the shapes and the width of the lines. But if you want to have a unique style, you can use the brush tool. Now if you have it set to default with nothing in it, it won't work. You have to press this button and choose one of the brushes that you have, or download some of them and install them. A new window will pop up. Select one of them, maybe this one. Decrease the size of it. Otherwise it will be big. If I just leave it to default, it's this big. But if I set it to 0.1, it's this big. And it's still a brush, as you can see. And the last one is the blob brush tool. It's similar to the brush and the pencil. You can double click on it to open the menu. change the size of it. We can change the angle and the roundness. The difference between all of the previous tools and the Blob Brush tool is that the Blob Brush tool creates shapes immediately. So this is a shape, but this was a stroke, and so was this. So if I just make one stroke with the Blob Brush tool, so you can see that it selects the outline, which is not the case with this. It selects the stroke. And if I add a stroke, you can see that it adds it to the outside. So this is a shape. And what you can also do with the Blob Brush tool is go over the shapes. Since the Blob Brush automatically makes shapes, it also connects them. But it has to be the same style, meaning also the same color. These are all different shapes because they don't have the same color. So if I make a shape like this, only the X will be selected. But if I make a shape over this, all of this will be selected and connected. And if I change a color back to this one, I will now connect all of these together. But if the color was something else, this will not connect. And these are the 5 ways that you can use to trace the image in Illustrator. Test them out, and in another video, I'll show you how you can easily color the image that you got. If you found this video helpful and you would like to see me do more Illustrator tutorials, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel and enable the bell notification icon so you don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital!